Hi, this is Dr. Jeff Joenig from Addiction Remission with a couple items of business. This is November 4th, 2013, T-minus about 6 hours before the Packer-Bear Monday Night Football game that I hope you'll all be watching with me. A couple things about buprenorphine and opioid dependence I'd like to mention. The first would be a couple websites that I've set up recently. One is called SuboxSearch.com, so SuboxSearch.com. What you can do there, I have two Google search algorithms, basically. One that searches my blog, the other that searches the forum, and you can enter whatever topic: surgery, pregnancy, you know, pain treatment on buprenorphine, and it uses the Google search algorithm to go through either the blog or forum, whichever one you choose. I encourage you to check it out. You know, for people who have questions about buprenorphine, especially the forum search is just incredible. I mean, it goes back about 6 or 7 years. There are about 15,000 threads of people talking about buprenorphine. And so on pretty much any topic, you will get someone asking a question and then answers by people generally who know. I mean, one thing about the forum, people are pretty good about describing whether their answer is a guess or whether they're comfortable with their answer. And so, you know, and the moderators, you know, they've been there for years and years, and they know what they're talking about. I go on and answer questions every now and then as well. It's just something when you search on this page to see all of these threads pop up. I mean, you can tell I am impressed by it. I just set it up relatively recently, and I'm just surprised at how well it works. Again, SuboxSearch.com. I believe BupTalk.com will get you there as well, but I know SuboxSearch does. The other thread is a doctor finder. And that's at the website suboxdocs.com, so SuboxDocs.com. What I have collected there are a number of databases that have been shared with me that help find doctors who prescribe buprenorphine. So there's the one from the Substance Abuse and Mental Health Society. There's one from the National, NAABT, National Alliance for Advocates for Buprenorphine Treatment. There are a couple private groups, and I think there may be five or six altogether. There's one from the company that Reckitt-Benckiser that makes the medication. You know, in a time when there's limited prescribers out there, check out the site, and I think you'll find it helpful. Again, that is suboxdocs.com. What else? I've added a page at Suboxone Talk Zone about the diversion of buprenorphine, and basically it's a Google news feed that talks about the bad side, the diversion of the medication, and that is an issue. I'm going to do some more talking about that in the near future and about what doctors I think could do to perhaps address that problem before the whole problem gets taken away from us by a government entity or something along that line. In the remaining few minutes, my last blog post, if anyone happened to see it, the point I was trying to make, it was about, I think it was the title was something like Other Ways to Stop Suboxone. But my point with it was that We are at a very interesting time for opioid dependence. We are at a time when the research really is at a critical area, and we may see a dramatic increase in the products that are available. In fact, we already have seen a dramatic increase when you consider in the last 10 years, we have Revia, which is oral naltrexone, Vivitrol, which is the naltrexone injection. We have buprenorphine, which is generic Subutex. We have Suboxone. We have Zubsolve. There are a couple other things on the horizon. So there already are some different new options out there for treating addiction. I talk about how when I was in med school back in the 1980s, you know, beta blockers, which are used to control blood pressure, consisted of maybe two or three medications. You know, we had propranolol and maybe metoprolol, and that was it. And so when we were writing a prescription, it was pretty straightforward. But in the last 20 years, you know, we have dozens of beta blockers now that are specific for this receptor, that have this side effect or that side effect. Unfortunately, addiction doesn't have the cachet of treating heart disease, but it does have, you know, a profit incentive. And so hopefully the pharmaceutical companies will respond to that profit incentive and do similar work with addiction as they have always done with other illnesses. So watch as we go forward. You know, to some people out there who are thinking, you know, should I stop buprenorphine, or people who've tried to taper and weren't able to complete the taper, you know, I ask them, just be patient, just get on with your life, take the medication, stay away from opioids and do well. And, you know, there may be something better. In the blog post, I talked about an antidepressant that was being made by Alkermes. And what the antidepressant, it's not approved at this point, but what it would consist of would be buprenorphine and then another drug to block the opioid effects, the mu receptor effects of buprenorphine, so that buprenorphine would act only at the other receptors where it works. Buprenorphine acts, for example, at kappa receptors, which are another type of opioid receptor. Normally, you don't see those effects because the effects at the mu receptor are so strong, they just kind of overwhelm the picture. But there's a little, a drug, I don't know how little it is, a drug called ELX-33. The name is little. And it's an analog, you know, a molecule that blocks specifically the mu opioid receptor. And it keeps buprenorphine from causing tolerance to develop there. And what I kind of proposed in my blog post was perhaps the people that are trying to taper off buprenorphine, instead of tapering off buprenorphine every day, taking less and less and less, perhaps someday there'll be a drug that they can take more and more and more of that blocks the mu receptor effects and causes tolerance to go away. And the value to that would be when someone is tapering off buprenorphine, they have to decide constantly, you know, 10,000, a million, whatever times a day, not to take more buprenorphine. On the other hand, if there was a choice to get up every morning and decide whether or not to take the next tapering dose of an antagonist, that would be a much different proposition that I think many people would have much more success with. So, cause for optimism for people with interest in, you know, neurochemistry like myself, an interesting time. And, you know, I still really believe that tolerance will be figured out in my lifetime. And I don't know, again, if that'll be good for the planet or bad for the planet, good for the species of humans to have pain relief and euphoria from opioids without tolerance. I mean, can you imagine? Does that mean, will there be medications to give people opioid effects, who have, we think, too little endorphin tone. When you think of something like that, I don't know, it certainly would change the world in a big way. And I really don't know if it would be a good thing or a bad thing. Feel free to comment. Let me know what you think. Please hit the subscribe button. Okay. And thanks for listening. I'll try to keep this interesting as best I can. I'll talk to you next week. Bye-bye.